What up, YouTubers? I am back. This is your true Canadian Stoner Queen, Tabby Cat, aka Tabby Cat 709 on Instagram. Go follow me on Instagram at any point in time. If you 18 and over, this channel is. And if you show negativity comics or comic below with your inappropriate comments, well, y'all be blocked. No negativity, people. Y'all can't leave. I'll show you the door. And that's the rule. It's being a bigger, better person than everybody's attention-seeking shit on YouTube. This is a positivity vibe, cannabis community, talented ways of showing who I am and what I can do, other than getting stoned anyway. So, if any point in time of you, give this video a thumbs up if you really like this video, and if you have any questions, comment below. I will do other videos for you guys if you have any questions, and we'll do some things to change it up, so keep it all in mind. So feel free to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Subscribe for subscribe, follow for follow on TabbyCat709 on Instagram. So this is take two on CBD vape pen or CBD hookah or e-hookah or whatever. If you want, search at cbdoilzone.com to learn more about it. This, on my last video, that I cut off early because everything was the last minute bullshit, but I have flavors of pens. I just finished my 500 puffs of blueberry. Delicious. I'm just doing peach right now. Tastes like peaches, like fuzzy peaches. And I got another blueberry and another peach and a mango. I'm going to try that very soon. I want to know, is my result in this video, if this gets stoned, or not stoned, but like if you relax, if you feel relaxed, not as high, but it's CBD. It says there does not contain THC, nicotine, or tobacco, which is funny when they said doesn't contain, because there's a pot leaf here and there's a pot leaf on this pen. And my question to, as a result, out in the real world is, does this pen get you high? Or not high, does this pen reduce anxiety, your pain? I can't answer about the pain, but does this reduce my anxiety? Is the video that I'm gonna do. So, let's get started. This is a very delicious pen, man. When it blinks like that, it just stops. That tells you that's your whole puff right there on a CBD e-hookah. It's just really fucking warm. I might open the window for a bit. Get some fresh air going. It smells so fucking peachy. Mmm. I don't know how many drugs it took off of this, just to know if it does reduce anxiety. The only reason why, this is confused in two ways. First of all, when I said there is, does not contain THC, nicotine, or tobacco, if it doesn't contain THC, then what the fuck is with the pot leaf fucking shit? I don't know. And it's CBD. So CBD, like, CBD is basically, like, supposed to be part of cannabis. And my result of thinking is, does this reduce my anxiety? And I can't answer about pain because pain's, I don't think this will reduce pain. But, I could say maybe it'll help quitting cigarettes, but I don't know. And this is just like a fucking cigarette. Like, it's really tasty. I got, like, my favorite was blueberry out of that. This bowl, fuck. I broke my bowl last night on my piece, so I had to buy a fucking $8 bowl, and this bowl sucks like fucking shit. So honestly, like, if I had to say, I'm trying to feel, I feel like a fucking light buzz, like, trying to smoke all of this fucking delicious peach shit right now. Delish, delish, delish. This is like a good it's a good video to like introduce new things to the world where people are gonna come across and be like, hey, what's up? So anyway, we're gonna hit a bong rip. I honestly don't think my, oh, there it is. Cheers, guys. I feel like I'm not high or anything. I just feel mellow. Like, I feel a little bit mellow. Like, relaxed. Is what I think. Anyway, cheers, guys. I just got a built-in glass, not a built-in glass screen, I just got a separate bowl and a glass screen put into the bowl. Because I don't want pull-throughs and silicone bong for a reason. And I'll show you why in a second. In another second. Okay, now. Right now. That's just fucking, the whole reason being is the silicone down stem in this bong. This is the first time I had a silicone down stem and I experienced this, but like this time, but if you do pole first, your bong gets clogged easily in that, and it really is hard to fucking do more tokes later on because it just gets clogged and it gets too chuggy. And what I do is put a glass screen to prevent that, and it keeps your bong cleaner and all that. And it's good, and it's important to keep this down stem and everything not so, like, rough. When you keep doing pull throughs, and later on when you're doing an art toke, it's gonna get harder and clogs it, and you don't want that. And it's also easier to change and clean it, rinse it. That's my other reason why. So it's always important to keep them clean. Like the CBD pen, I honestly feel like maybe it's just like a false advertisement about the marijuana part, but I don't have much anxiety on me, but if I did, I should have just done a YouTube part. But next time I'll keep that in mind. When it does happen and later on in the future. Sucks though, but it's something I gotta live with, I guess. Gotta make sure. I know it's a little warm in here, so I just gotta like do what I gotta do. CBD pen, take two, man. Cheers. Two fucking big inhales. Whew. If you had like maybe a bong rip and smoked that, you probably get kicked it in more because of it. But it's not really bad, really, if you think of it. It's pretty fucking good, man. It's really freaking good. And cheers. Aren't you that person from Toke TV? Because I don't even know if you are or aren't. There's so many people on this freaking subscribing my channel or from Toke TV, which I'm really surprised they all fucking from Toke TV caught on with that. Toke TV, like honestly lately, has been a cocksucker to me because there was a huge glitch going on in my freaking life and I can't catch up any videos, so I'm like posting here, posting on Instagram, posting everywhere the fuck I guess in the world. I'm doing a video clip on CBD oil zone, and it's 100% illegal hemp CBD, does not contain THC, nicotine, or tobacco. And this is a review video where I'm gonna say, does this thing, instead of saying getting you high, does this thing actually reduce my anxiety? And that was really hard to say in this video than my last video, because my last video I had a bit of anxiety, but right now I don't. I kind of a little do, but most of it I don't. So I should have fucking done this video for this until next time. It's all right. It's okay. So my bowl, my Rasta color bowl for this broke last night when I went over to my brother's, and his apartment's on the fucking top floor, free stairs up or whatever. The one night I was thinking, that night I was like, what else if my fucking bowl went over the fucking edge? And it did. My bomb tilt lost the bowl, rolled off the edge, and it fell all the way down, and it smashed on the fucking ground. The only thing I found all the pieces, by the way, with my brother's boyfriend, but what I had, had was all the missing pieces. This survived from the fall. It only smashed right the fuck here. My glass screen was still in there from the fall. That was fucking awesome. And it was worth it. And like, it was worth to fucking get my glass screen back. And I bought a bowl from last night. This is the bowl anyway. It's my $8 bowl of Genie. I wouldn't use this in my silicone. I'd rather use this bowl in something else. I actually like this bowl the way it looks. It's not so steep and all, but I fucking hate this fucking, how it fucking happened yesterday, really. I didn't cry. I was like, Josh? Yeah. Did it? Yeah. Really over the edge? Yeah. Fuck! What am I gonna do? So, I was screwed on getting high. And then, finally found a bowl. Paid $8 for it. It's like, fuck it. We found a bowl. And that's it. We got it. And I came across these CBD vape pens or e-hookahs or the fuck ever the hell. And I'm trying to figure out if it does mellow you down. And this is a super reason. Like I'm going to say this. It says no THC, right? And I just said no THC, nicotine, and tobacco. Why the fuck is there a fucking pot leaf on this thing? Like, anybody could tell me what the hell it is. It's not a fucking logo of, like, if they kind of, like, give you a logo for false advertisement, I, like, would say, like, honestly, I would want to say to find out more by researching www.cbdoilzone.com to fucking know what, if this is, like, what it is. It'll tell you more info about it. Really peachy. I'm gonna start research it on too later on. Come back with another live. I should have had a fucking... I have a laptop. I'm just not in the mood to open it tonight, honestly. I don't really use the laptop because too much effort, too much whatever. I'm actually thinking about putting the laptop downstairs and put it on the table in the bar room. That I should be doing that. At least it gives me some time to, like, do whatever, I guess, but yay. I'm gonna pack a bowl in. I have my Skittles bowl and fucking... Or bong. Skittles bong. Fucking wax me bong. Wax me named Skittles. Okay, whatever. I gotta reorder this bowl. But the problem is when I do order it, they're gonna give me a random choice color in the category. So I really hope they do give me that exact color bowl again. So cross my heart. I gotta order it tonight. is no fucking way I am lasting with this. And that's gonna suck for, oh, I can order it tonight. I gotta wait for my pay. I was gonna order it, but now I gotta wait for a bunch of things. The reason being is that in my shopping cart right now, the items in my cart, some of the items are not in the fucking, they're not in the, on the page anymore, for like, even they're sold out or for some reason or whatever. So I have to like keep it there for now until I have the money, until I want to order all of it. Even the shirt, I want to get a Pixford shirt that I had to get, and it's in my category and it's not even on the page anymore. And I still have an advance to like ship it out or lose it for good until they come back. And that's hard to say when. So yeah. I'll figure it out. Cheers. Yeah, it kind of sucks, but oh well. It works. I'd rather use this bowl on a fucking glass bonk than for the silicone. It doesn't function as better as the other bowl before it smashed. Fuck's sakes. But I still got this piece. We can smoke at it right now. And this is my Cheech Bong, Avril Lavigne, my straight tube. I'll give you guys a demonstration. This is not the original bowl for it. That broke as well back like in the springtime in April. For God's sakes, I was cleaning it that day and the orange crown made it so slippery that it slipped out of my hand. Bang the fucking corner of the counter and it fell right on the ground. Separate the bottom and the bowl at the same time. The end. So when you do clean your bongs, be careful how you fucking handle your glass. Always. I regret a lot of fucking shit. I broke 3 glass this year. 2 bowls and a bong. I actually survived last year without breaking one single fucking thing. And the other year, I think. Yeah, the other year. The other year, actually, my uncle... Actually, last year, my uncle smashed my bong almost 2 years ago. The last time I really broke my own glass was, like, a couple years ago. So, 2 years, and now this year, I broke 3 fucking glass. 2 bowls and a fucking bong. It's still refixable about the bong part, but I'm really pissed it only lasted a month before it broke. Yeah. I'm gonna get an art piece anyway and go from there. Right now, I'm gonna try not to fucking break my glass before I gotta get other shit replaced. I gotta really replace that fucking bowl for that my silicone wax made bong. And I wanna get some nice expensive bowls, but I'm really, really, really scared at that risk right now, so I don't know if I should. If I do, the bowls are staying home. The expensive bowls are fucking staying home. Just like my Urban Glass, $500 bong, but I was looking for a $400 one. Cheapest or the lowest anyway that I can go, but a brand new bong in the bong shop for $450, why not? The other guy who I was going to buy it off of, and he ripped me off that night, he was going to sell it to me for $400 used. Plus, he chipped the end, but he lowered it to $380. But I also, it's also a different kind of pink. It was called a slime pink. It's like a Pink Panther color. And it really reflects the light, and it's pretty. All the Urbans, that's why I love the Urban Glass. When you put them in the light, even it sparkles, shines, or fucking changes color. The one I got now, I love this pink better because it had bubbles inside, and when you put in the light, it fucking reflects, it shines, it sparkles, it like shines sparkles kind of thing. I like it. Through my bowl, my downstep, and the top of the mouth part, everything else was all clear glass, and the Urban Glass is just frosted lettering. And they had the other Urban Glass where it's just like the logo's like this kind of thing. And I like frosted glass better, so I was like, fuck it. I like the frosted logo better than the... It looks nicer, neater, it's not so much whatever. And if you get bongs like this, and it's like a very risky thing to take care of, but you gotta take care of them with care on how you gotta make sure this stays on all your time instead of losing all the paint job or whatever you have on your bong. When you do clean this, and when you're using rubbing alcohol, that will eat up the paint. And not only that, but like when you're drying it, you're rubbing on it, that will take it off too. So what I recommend to do is make sure it's in the fucking tube, not all over your fucking bong. And when you dry it, don't fuck. I saw people swinging their fucking bong like this to air dry it. And I saw my bong friend, my stoner friend who I went to school with, and she did that in one of her live videos on how to clean a bong or some stupid shit, and she's like fucking air drying it like this, like, because she had it because I think her bong had paint, I think at that time it had like paint coated on this, but I thought at that time she had like complete glass, and she's air drying her fucking piece like this. And I was like, if that slipped out of your hand on live, I'd be fucking sitting here and laugh the shit, because that was stupidity. If you try to avoid that, and because of it, even let it air dry or just give it a little pat. Don't rub it, just pat it like you're patting your, drying your face off or whatever. Because all you're doing is you're taking it off. And Orange Chronic or rubbing alcohol, because Orange Chronic has rubbing alcohol, isopropyl, that will eat it up for sure. And the downstem, when it's painted, whatever, saying cheech or whatever, and your downstem fades because three reasons on the downstem. Your smoke, when you're smoking out of it, it does kind of like change color, like to your logo, like it kind of changed the color in this downstem, like it kind of fading, but it won't fade, like, because it's silicone, but you know what I mean. Even that, poppers fucking like ruins the whole bong anyway. Tobacco destroys your tasting of weed, destroys your bong in general. Reasons of that, of like going back to the like stuff like this, this will wear off, or the downstem. I wouldn't say this, but the downstem would. The perks inside your bong will get a sting in it. It won't be like, I had a cheat song named Anaconda. And it had an 85 hole honeycomb perk. People were doing, and I told people not to do fucking poppers in my bong, aka batch, aka tobacco with weed. Meanwhile, I found out my bong had tobacco shit in it, plus my perk changed the color. It wasn't a glass pink, it was an orangey tint pink. That took a couple of weeks to get rid of the taste. And the fucking sting of the color. And that's, and I got it all out, but it's just so ignorant how people fucking do that. If you want to do fucking poppers, go smoke a fucking blunt, because all you're doing is stinging your fucking bong. All you're doing is stinging your fucking bong, your fucking perks, your fucking downstem, everything. And it'll take, who knows how long it will take to fucking clean it. I don't smoke poppers out of it. But all in one day, when people were fucking smoking poppers, I don't know how long, because I haven't caught on to it. It does take a couple of weeks to get rid of it. Other bongs might take, oh fuck, who knows, maybe a couple months, maybe a few months. Unless you keep on top of it, of cleaning it every other day, maybe soak it, maybe it'll go less by that. I do it every so often is the reason, and it took me a couple of few weeks. if I do it almost like every day or every day, it should have been less than that, but fuck that. People are just fucking stupid on how the fuck to take care of their own bong sometimes. And a chick like this, air drying it, oh my god, what is she fucking on, yo? Me, personally, when I have bongs like this, I pat it, and when it's glass, you can just fucking dry the fuck out of it if you want. Just avoid all paint parts when you're gonna dry it. Like, don't rub it, just pat it. And when it's glass, just fucking do it. Just, like, give it a nice, like, dry off, whatever. Cheers to Avril Lavigne. It's already been over a year. It's October 6th, 2017. And we already passed that day anyway, a long time ago. So, four score and three weeks ago. Fuck's sakes, man. Time flies. My first straight tube I ever owned actually broke about a month to 3 months later, because I left my straight tube since day one I bought it down the road for me. And everybody back then used to live over there. Now it's just the dad and his one son. Everybody was living back there. And I made some rules about it and say, I know you guys like the bong. And I say, yeah, you could smoke it when I'm not there. But my rule of thumb is, because like I had the bong, every time I was gone, the bong was always put in the dad's room. And that's because the risk of people gonna break it. Well, I say, I guess, like, I trust you guys, okay? But if you're gonna smoke my bong, my straight tube, smoke it in the living room. Don't bring it anywhere. No batches, no poppers, you guys know that. They know that I don't do that, and they don't do it anyway. Other rule of thumb is, because the two boys, one was Shark Bay and the other one, I want to say Vancouver Canucks fan or whatever. I'm just like, San Jose and whatever, fuck. Shark Bay and his other brother, well, they like playing Call of Duty. And in Shark Bait's room, his room is so fucking scrunched up because there's a bunch of fucking junk and all his shit in my way and everywhere. You know what I'm saying? When you first walk in and everything's like fucking like a hoarder. Well, his room is pretty tight kind of that way back then. I made room to put my bong on top of the fucking shelf or whatever. And I said this too, if you guys are gonna smoke the bong while playing video games, you can do that. My thought of theory is, when you are done with it, move it out of the fucking way on the floor. Don't put it on the floor. I said don't put it on the floor because the bong's in the way where they're sitting. Don't put it on the side either because it's still on the floor. Put it back on this fucking shelf. Always when you want to smoke it, put it right there. Or put it somewhere out of the way, or bring it in the living room. That's fine. I said, when you're done with it, put it back in the living room. The one night, Shark Rape took the fucking bong in his room, and he was smoking weed, playing video games. He passed out right next to my bong. What does he do overnight? He swung his arm as he's turning, hit the bong. He broke this whole fucking part right here and the downstem. The bowl survived. Like, I have the bowl for it that survived from my chillax bong. I like this bong better than my chillax, but this is the bowl that survived from the bong years ago. Now fucking today, or not today, but back then, he just, like, I told him. He was so worried how he was gonna tell me how he broke his bong, because he feel like I was a freak out. And when his dad told me, his name was Maple Tree, he told me about it. I went like this. It's like, I told him so. And that's what he gets. I even said, if you were fucking done, you put it back. And I told him because I knew that was going to happen. It happened because he put it in the fucking way when he passed out. He felt so bad because he knows, like, everything I said to him is like, I predicted it and I was right about it. And he felt pretty shitty about it. I said, you know what, just because that happened, it's just like, because, you know, I'm telling you these things because this just recently happened and I predicted it. But it doesn't stop you from smoking on my stuff. It's not like you purposely did it. It's just, oh shit, it happens and you learn from it and now you know. And now it's like a consequence that he had to owe me $80 back. And then later on, he broke my Haas glass. I opened the door as I was gonna open the door and he swung it open from the inside when he opened it and he fucking hit my bong that cracked it. And he had to owe more money to that, and that was a $200 bong that I paid for. But I wanted to replace those two broken bongs. That this bong was originally $200, but I paid it a lot, so he saved $50 off. Plus other cash money on my Bumblebee piece, so he paid for this off of me. I love this piece better than my Haas glass and my chillax, all in total. So I was happy I got my dream piece of my Cheech Bong in here, so. I paid for this from the beginning when I ordered it, but then he paid me off for it. I told him, I'm going to buy a bong and I'm going to show you the fucking receipt on it and you're going to pay me off. So it took quite a bit for him to pay me off for $154. That was it. I told him that's how much it is. $154. But I think he gave me $160. I think he'd give me $160, but he still smokes out of my bong. If I, like, it's been a long time, like, hearing from him, but if he was around, I'd let him still smoke in my piece. It's not like he did it purposely. It's just when you have my glass, be careful of it, and when anything breaks, they gotta own up for it. Because everything they touch is all on them. If I touch their bong, that's all on me. Like an expensive bong, and if it broke, I will have to pay the consequences on careless shit or shit happens moment. And this is an every tree stoner thing where you have to own up to it, because like when you break a bong, and even people say, oh, don't worry about it and all this shit, I think it's good enough just to be nice. And just like, my thought is, it depends on the person. I'm not saying everybody should be like this, but like, if you are a true stoner like me, I would honestly, if I break somebody's bong, would pay up for it, even if it's an accident. And if people say it's all right, you don't need to get me a newer one or all shit, they'll get a newer one themselves. Well, yeah, but no, it doesn't. It all depends on the situation, I guess. But if I would do it still, if I wanted, if I do anyway, right? Because they probably don't have enough. They can't afford, or transportation. A lot of reasons, anyway. But yeah. A lot of reasons. Cheers, guys. Avril Lavigne, Halloween style. This weed is pretty shitty, I gotta admit, on YouTube. I'm not pleased with this fucking weed at all. So, actually, what I am going to do is I am going to pull this out. Keep all the shitty weed. Oh, this smells so fucking good. I can't wait. I can't wait to fucking smoke it already. This smells better than the stuff I'm smoking on. It's not their fault, the people who give this to me. It's because whoever they get it off of, even their stuff is old, dry, or it's pretty shitty on where the fuck it comes from. I think my friend's person they're going through with is not impressed either by the tell of the taste and this. Like, the smell was good or all right, but then you smoke it, it's like, fuck, you lose your fucking buzz. So what I do is just, like, start filling up some good weed in this fucking jar for now. I might use this jar, for other fucking temps. Like, actually, I don't even know if this would work. All right, I guess it all depends. But counts. What else? Keep that, keep that. Wait a second. Maybe I could start putting this fucking... Oh, bad idea. Because now it is stuck in my freaking bong. I thought it was smart, but I think it's not. Okay, whatever. Not working. I'll keep my vape pens in here. That's not it. A disposable one. And go from there, I guess. Just put a bunch of fucking whatever in here for now. I was gonna use this, but in the future I will. Just put it in here as whatever. And that just happened, so that was like half the time's embarrassing right now. Give me a sec. I gotta move some shit. There we go. Okay, well, that's all I can do. Drop me. Light. Okay. That was a really bad temptation. I'm using my phone, by the way, so, like, that just takes out my whole attention. Okay. Fuck's sakes. Stay the fuck up. Oh, I'm having bad times. Technical difficulties. Okay, there. Fuck. Cheers. Wrong way. Cheers. longest time I ever took an inhale for. Whew. That was really fucking peachy. I really hope I get a lot of subscribers of the future for trying to put an effort out there. I'm not making fucking Papa fucking logo videos to all this shit because it takes too much time. A lot of editing. I hate editing, like, a lot because it's just, it's so impatient for me just to sit there and do it. I just do more editing for Instagram, for example. I won't edit in my fucking videos like this for YouTube. No way. Because if you're gonna do this, you're gonna do this the real way or the not the fake way. So. I'm gonna pack an herbal. This weed really is shitty, I gotta admit. It's not my, like I said, the people at GoTo's fault because whoever they had it off, I bet that person is upset about it too, where he had it from and relied on. He's never getting it again kind of thing. It's just dirty. The stuff I had, like, from them, the newer stuff now I'm gonna smoke later on after all this old other shit's gone. This one smells fucking 100 times better than the shit I'm smoking on. And I bet it'll taste 100 times better than the shit I'm smoking on right now. I'll show you. This looks healthy. But why would they sell me, like, this kind of shitty fucking shit? Like, it's all fucking crumbs. Again, it smells the bag, like everything, it smells good, but when you smoke it, it's like, fuck, it's old or dead and dry or some shit. Shitty fucking, like, it's kind of basically called shitty weed for that. But, like, I don't know why it smells so good, but it fucking just turns out like shit. Or smells good, or smells alright, or whatever, right? Right. I'll just put it back in my weed jar. I guess continue smoking on the live stream anyway, right? Right. Y'all bitches think you got something to prove. But then again, I got nothing to lose. And I ain't just fucking, I got nothing to do. Run through these tracks like there was I'm in my shoe. Y'all bitches think you got nothing to lose. But then again, I got something to prove. And I ain't just fucking, I got nothing to do. Running through these tracks like there was on in my shoes. So don't get geeked up. Bitch, don't put your feet up. Move it till you're grooving if you want to keep your beat. As of a bitch, don't get oh, fuck. I fucked up. I'm not feeling it. I'm not feeling the fucking high that I should get for this shit. To be honest. Like, a proper medicate, you know. No, I hate saying high because then you think, what are you high off of, right? I would say medicate. Number two, Avril Lavigne. Cheers. Feel that one. First I was alright when you hit a little, but when you hit a fat toe, you feel it after, and that's just dirty. That's like fucking disgusting. I'm glad it's almost done, this whole fucking old shit I have. Because, like I said, this, I got better stuff from them like the other stuff I got from them recently than this shit. I should have told them about it too. I didn't want to break their fucking heart, but I'm gonna say the last stuff that you guys gave me was pretty shitty. I should have been. It's not like. I'm pretty sure they fucking knew about it too. I don't know what's really going on there, but. Like. My friend used to deal with these people, and because she came back with less than 15 bucks worth, she was supposed to get a quarter, and she. My other friend called me because, she had bought weed, and she feel like she got ripped off because it wasn't the course she was thinking, and she asked if I had a scale and all that. I said, yeah, come over, I'll put the dog and everything away or whatever, bring the scale. So I did, and as I brought the scale out, they showed up, they walked in, so the first thing I do is weigh it. My friend doesn't even know how much a fucking quarter is on eighth and, or a quarter or an eighth on how much of grams of weed. And I said, if you get an eighth, you get 3.5, 3.6 grams. If you get a quarter, it all depends on a person, but they can give you between 6.5 or 7 grams of weed. And neither of that, she just got 5.5, and so she like got ripped off by 15 bucks. 5.4, 5.5, so she's got ripped off by like 15 bucks. I prefer smoking out of the bong. I'm a bong chick. This is my first time doing, and I like vapes, but I rather smoke out of a bong. It's my thing. Some people prefer smoking out of a pipe than a bong, a joint than a bong. Prefer smoking bubblers, prefer whatever. They prefer what the fuck ever they want to smoke out of, I guess. I'm a bong chick. I like, prefer smoking in the bongs out of anything, really. It's easier, and I can't roll joints, but I smoke a joint here and there with people. I actually recently smoked one the other two nights ago with fucking Lisa. I smoke with this one person from my hometown. She's pretty freaking cool. Whoop, and then I drop my phone again. If it goes any further with this phone, I might as well fucking just like call the YouTube people about this shit. Anyway, I'm gonna smoke. I should push it down a bit because of my Avril Lavigne. Is all I can be. Cheers, guys. And it's not going to be the greatest one either for now. Might as well add a little THC on top. Cheers. Dirt in my pool for that's just dirty. Even when I changed the water, it wasn't the water, it was just the fucking weed. Oh fuck. I'm never again like fucking, like if I ever fucking come across that again, I swear I'm gonna tell these people this weed I got is pretty fucking shitty. And I actually want other good stuff than this. I want to take it back and I'll smoke the fucking shit I fucking smoked. I already weighed it before I test it, because literally the one time before you guys give me Death Star, the other time when I got it is because, like, it was in crumpets, and not only that, it was really fucking shitty. Yeah. See what I mean? Joints after cigarettes. This is just a peachy CBD e-hookah. It has no THC in it, no nicotine, no tobacco. But why is there a pot leaf on this thing? It's like CBDOilZone.com, right? And I do not understand why the fuck they have this pot leaf. And it can't just be a fucking advertisement. Like, that's like the stupidest thing they ever fucking do. Like, right? It was $16 for this vape pen. They are disposable. I have a vape. I gotta change the coil and something fucking is really going on, because what the hell is going on? Holy fuck. You know what? I'm gonna start cutting off YouTube for now if this keeps it up. Anyway, Jesus. It's just fucking bad luck right now. My fucking vape juice is like not even brown anymore. It's like red. I gotta fucking dump it. I gotta change everything. That's why I stopped smoking it. I gotta fucking find out what's going on. I gotta go on YouTube and figure this. Smock Alien. Let me guess. I'm smoking the fucking wrong way again. No, I'm not. Oh. I see where it's coming from. Cool. So, yeah. Cheers, guys. I'd rather sell this fucking weed than smoke it right out. Well, I ain't gonna lose, right? I want to order some, but I have problems ordering shit because, I don't know, I feel like I'm doing something wrong. I don't get tour by things from people, and I just don't get help for it, I guess. I just don't got help for it. I don't know. It's so confusing for me, really. Everybody gets it, and I don't. I guess I could get big, like, I'm, fuck it. Oh, fuck. Wait, my friend want, hold on, I got a message. Missed it too. I'm not gonna cancel this live right now. I need a cigarette. Now, this week kind of gives me a headache too, so. Would I recommend get those pens, like those cigarette CBD ones? I say yeah and no. They say yeah and no. Yeah, because it tastes good. It's something different to fucking smoke on. And it's pretty fucking interesting. No, because no THC, but this fucking pot plant thing, like, what the fuck is this then, right? CBD oil? And why the fuck is there a fucking pot plant on it? It kind of concerns me. It says 15 milligrams of CBD. And I'm not sure because I smoke weed every day and I said, maybe you could feel the fucking, like, a fucking whatever. It's not even a different feeling than whatever. It's just like, I don't know what you want to say, but I'm trying to get to the point. It just feels like a little certain mellow, maybe, but I can't see that, but it just tastes so good anyway. It does. The blueberry one's my favorite. I can't kind of wait to try the mango one. I only have five of them last night. And a bowl. I paid fucking $100 and something fucking off of it. Because $60 a pen. Plus whatever fucking tax they're fucking from. To be fucking honest, I feel like that was just like a little fucking overboard over there for some reason. But it's something to try something new as a review for YouTubers out there. So feel free to subscribe to my channel. Follow for follow on TabbyCat799 on Instagram. And keep my stories and streams, posts on Instagram is really, really slacking because I'm more active on lives and stories than I am on posts because it's just a lot of editing. And back to that, it's so fucking much. So much. Sometimes I wanted a logo on the bottom to pop up for my thing anyway, for my Instagram. Question is, I don't know how. Like all the other people, it's so easy for them, but I'm using my phone, right? So when I'm done, I post it on fucking YouTube, pretty much. Go from there. It's a stream, it's whatever. It's whatever. What brand of cigarettes do you smoke? I smoke DK mediums right now. Full flavors are way like a head brush and it hurts and it sucks and I hate about cigarettes that way. They're reserve cigarettes, basically. But they're Canada duty paid. Some people buy bags and they're not Canada duty. When it all depends in Canada, when you buy cigarettes, they have to have this to show that it's illegal for a candidate like me to smoke. But if people get a pack like that, like without one, and this is all dependent between natives and white people or other people like me or anybody who's not native, I would say. If anybody who's not native gets a bag of cigarettes without this, it's illegal for them to smoke and they could be charged with that, and which is stupid. Like, fuck. That's the stupidest thing ever. But if you're native, you gotta have your native card and you get tax-free and all this shit. And not only that, but if you're native, yeah, when you're native, you gotta have a native card on you at all time. And when you go buy something from a store and there's taxes in Canada, that native card with that native person doesn't have to pay taxes. Because the history, culture of the land that they offered for back then, kind of thing. It was a native land that was offered away or something. And they had to, like, agree to whatever back then. And then, yeah. So they get away with the cigarettes, even the people, like, cigarettes without the tag, but, like, a tag. This is, I can smoke these are illegal to me, but if I smoke them without it, then it's illegal. But, funny story is, I smoke things without this all the fucking time. All the fucking time, because I think it's just, like, half the time's bullshit. Money is fucking money. They're still gonna sell it anyway. If they know it's illegal to people like me, they wouldn't be selling it, but they sold it anyway because money is money. That's why I fucking don't get in Canada. Like, I don't. Welcome to fucking life, right? But recently, pot's legalized since October 4th. No, I lied. When the fuck was it? October the 18th? Yeah, October the fucking 18th. That's when, wait, I lied. Where the fuck is it? October the 17th, I lied. October the 17th, 2018 is when pot was legalized in Canada and we're all getting high. But the only difference in Canada about this legalization is it all has to be prescribed. And if things in bags that are not prescribed, it's illegal too. Like, here it goes again. Back to that again. Like the cigarette story. But now, if you get caught smoking and driving or having a bag of weed and something on you like that, they'll fucking bang you right there too. This is fucking, this is like, this is something I don't get really in Canada. Like, Canada is a beautiful place, but sometimes it's like half of the time's bullshit too. But not everywhere is gonna be perfect, but we all have to live our own lives and work things out and figure shit out too, you know, on how things can be better than it is now. Which I have my slight suggestions. Like, when I go somewhere, I would honestly bring it in a container. I would honestly bring it in a fucking, because you're fucking, you gotta like be aware, right, in Canada. I bring something small. I don't have to bring something, like all of my pieces are big and all that shit, but. And this CBD has a fucking scent-proof cap, so like, I don't get it. Peachy. I'll see you back on Talk TV or whatever. You'll see you when you come back or on my next stream or whatever. I don't know how everything works in time zones, but yeah. Subscribe, follow on Instagram, TabbyCat799. Like this channel. Feel free to comment below for positivity vibes. Y'all bitches think you got something to prove, but then again, I got nothing to lose, and I ain't just fucking, I got nothing to do, running through these checks like there was on my shoes, so don't get geeked in. Okay, I'm trying to unravel some hemp wick, but I'm having troubles on the double. La, 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 la. There we go. It's my hemp light. I got a lot of cruddy too. It used to fill to the top, but I took some lately, so I want to make some room, give it a good shake. Now she does it like this, now she does it like that, now she touches like this, now she touches like that, now she looks like this, but she looks like that, come on, shake, 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 shake it, 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 now she does it like this, now she does it like that, now she touches like this, now she touches like that, now she looks like this, but she looks like that, come on, shake, 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 shake it, shake, 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 shake it, shake, 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 shake it, shake, 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 shake it. Oh my god, I haven't heard that song in a long, long, long time. But I just can't pull myself away, but I just trying to escape. I just can't stop. But I just can't pull myself away, but I just trying to escape. I can't stop, I can't stop, I can't stop, but I just gotta pull myself away on my special brand new day. I just can't stop, I just can't stop, I just can't stop, I just can't stop.
My heart thumps and you jump, coming down with goosebumps. You never go there. I'ma get you so scared. Want it too. I'm loving you. Want it too. You stayed in too late to be getting afraid. This thing is extreme. I'ma get you so scared. You gotta get your body shaking, wishing you could just a wig. I fucking can't believe Halloween is coming up.
Actually, you know what? Let's do this. Let's blow everybody's minds out on YouTube today. I think I'm into this today. I think I got it. But before we're gonna play this,
ready to dress up.
Oh, my God.
afraid. It's too late to be getting afraid. This thing extreme, I'ma get you so scared. Gotta get your body shaking, wishing you could just the wig. Tonight all the monsters gonna dance. We're coming to get ya. Tonight all the monsters gonna dance. We're coming to get ya. If you're only dreaming, but I hear you screaming. Tonight all the monsters gonna dance. We're coming to get ya. You had all your jackets to mow goodbye. We threw to your jail, but we're bucking for a free go. We might just bite underneath the moonlight. More fun if you run. I'm already shaking. Gotta get your body shaking, wishing you could just awake. Tonight all the monsters gonna dance. We're coming to get ya. Tonight all the monsters gonna dance. We're coming to get ya. If you're only dreaming, what I hear you screaming. Tonight all the monsters gonna dance. I'm gonna paint it red, get inside your head, head, head. Like a day with choir, play with fire, fire, fire. Tonight all the monsters gonna dance. We're coming to get ya. If you're only dreaming, why I hear you screaming. Tonight all the monsters gonna dance. We're coming to get ya. Coming to get ya.
Okay, now, like, because Halloween Countdown's coming on, I'm gonna fucking, like, play something that anybody don't know. What the hell? CBD Live with the Ghostbusters! This is fucking weird. I don't know why.
Thank you.
wants to kiss. I for you no kiss.
Peace out, guys. We're gonna cancel my live now. Thank you for watching. Subscribe to my YouTube channel. Like for like. Or follow for follow on TabbyCat799 on Instagram. Subscribe. Like this video. Thank you for watching. I know this is crazy. A little twist for me singing. I don't care. I'm just being myself, so I don't fucking care what anybody thinks. I want to be me, and this is me. Peace. I can't believe it. Fuck you. I can't believe that, like, Halloween's coming up. Right on, my motherfuckers. Subscribe to my channel and follow for follow on TabbyCat799 on Instagram. What the fuck, comic? I know that's you. You fucking squidding the fuck out of it. We talked about this. Quit it. I already know that was the first impression. Anybody else who freaking else puts a squid as their first conversation is Comet. What the hell? Huh. No. No fucking squids allowed. This is a fucking octopus. We talked about this. I knew it. It is you, Comet. You fucking... You son of a bitch. And I was gonna fucking jump off too and you popped in. What the hell? Every time I'm coming off, we just talked about this too. You don't... You gotta subscribe to my YouTube channel, buddy. You haven't subscribed yet. Stay tuned, or I'll catch me outside. How about that? For the next 30 minutes, why don't you suck on my fucking... Subscribe to my YouTube channel. No, no, no. Comic is in the freaking way. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Comic, you fucking... Can't believe you. Why is your name so freaking different? You see. Oh, maybe I get it, but... I just use my... Sanctuary YouTube. I fucking sure as hell I know you so well. What? All right, be down a sec. Nah. I said I'll be down.
Shut the fuck up.
You shut the fuck up, you fucking Sanchez. Or I'll contact you right in the fucking contacts. I'm a savage, am I? I'm a freaking savage. Like my channel. Subscribe. subscribe. Give you a death stare. Definitely death stare. Okay, that is really fucking bad of me doing that on YouTube, and millions of people are gonna watch that. Cool. I mean, like, fuck this one fucking Nickelodeon kid named JoJo. He's just like, hey, JoJo, and I was like, what are you saying? Holy fuck! Like, holy shit! What is this fucking kid on you? My fuck, man. I'll tell you what. I'm gonna finish this cigarette. I'm gonna jump off. I gotta go downstairs. I don't know if I'm going to work in the morning. I'm suggesting I'm gonna take a day off. Say I'm gonna take a sick day off in front of my dad. Because I don't fucking wanna fucking go on a fucking Monday. Everybody fucking knows she just drives me nuts. It's like, I'm taking a sick day. I got enough E-days to fucking last. You dose a fucking on a freaking ghost, nigga. Well, I really hate getting up so early. And the other thing is, like, I don't have my proper supervisor at work again because it's my ex-supervisor who's coming back and giving everybody heck again. And literally, I lost my shit on Friday, and literally, fucking smashed apart at a broken bed, and she checked on me later, and she's like, the first thing she ever said was, nobody's perfect, blah, 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 and she knows she dried me out of my fucking skin. Like, how are we supposed to fucking, like, I gotta stop and do this, I gotta stop. When the bin changes, when I gotta fucking tell them, I'm gonna grab pins, I'm gonna fucking, like, dot things, I can't fucking help that. And you know what? Even so, like, yeah, this one person, the second lead hand helper, should have been fucking doing it to kind of pitch in a bit, but it's not really her fucking job either way. If she has nothing to do, that's fine, but if she had something to do, she has something to do. Instead of, like, it's an operator's job. You can't just say we can't fucking do something that we got told by HQ. Or QA. Like, QA. What the fuck? She asked the dumbest question why we marked those. Recently, she knew we were marking them before she stopped in her supervisor. Like, she knew about this. How come she come back and said, why do we gotta do this? Like, we went through this. And recently, fucking, the other shift fucking sent out parts that were all painted black by between the one side or the other side, and they never checked on them, and they're not supposed to send out parts like that because that's part of it anyway. They gotta take the paint off. Can't believe I did that. Holy fuck. Now we gotta still mark them for a while now, the way it sounds, because nobody trained them properly is the fucking case why it happened. And I see that guy on the pinning thing, and he's pretty new, and he fucking just fucked everything over pretty much. Some people did piss poor fucking shit lately. They gotta really fucking work fast. Now a couple of weeks we put fucking the supervisor over there. Something's really going on the other shift too. They're slacking off. And the fucking other person's not doing his fucking job anyway. Like, this one person, he's not even... Like, I don't understand. He's probably getting shit anyway for all the bullshit. He's not a really good supervisor, I gotta say, the way the fucking marks are. Even the machine was problems or what. I feel like they're really fucking really slow. Because fuck, they're fucking lazy. They show up and they don't catch up the fucking line fast enough. They sleep in, we get up early and gotta work fast. Everybody sleeps in and they work slow. Like, holy fuck.
I afraid of ghosts. Dude, 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 dude. You dose of my freaking ghost, nigga. Baby. Like button, subscribe button, both handed. Y'all gotta be so cool. But sometimes I act like a fool on life. If you wanna die, gotta keep my time. Don't wanna do the crime. I don't know why I'm doing this right now. You dose on my freaking ghost, baby. I just wanna say, come on. Write me a gown before you write me a rose. Covering up before we're covered in gold. It's trying on, gonna tell me out. Say what you want, but I will never be told. I'm in love with the monster. Oh, friends, I am super. Friends, I am stupid. I'm out of my mind. But without you, boy, the bored of my time. No, I really care for a single conversation. I can't do it. Kinda not. Better than the other day. I'm almost done my cigarette anyway. Since you subscribe, I hope to see you again on this live channel. I'm gonna slowly cut down Toke TV because of the reasons where I'm not getting everything I'm getting really right now and then. And I'm gonna do 23 birthday things right now on this live channel, so that's until next year though. Not until next year. Anyways, I gotta jump off. I'll see you in my next stream. Thank you for the subscribe, follow, and peace the hell out.